Hi students, all of you, good morning. Welcome to the class, Polymers, class 2 revision class. And here again, I am revising the concepts. If you understand the concepts, then only you can go through the CET or NEET or JEE MCQs. So today's our topic is about, this is the one, condensation polymerization. Before that one, yesterday we studied about addition polymerization. To undergo addition polymerization, what is the condition? The condition is monomers must be unsaturated. Unsaturated means that the monomers must contain either double bonds or triple bonds. Then such monomers, upon polymerization, the reaction is leading to addition polymerization, and the formed polymer is called as addition polymer. Yesterday we studied this one. Again, when polymerization is going to be happen with the help of only one type of monomer units. If the polymerization is carried by using of only one type of monomer units, such polymerization is called as homopolymerization, and the formed polymer is called as homopolymer, or simply the homopolymer is called as homomer. Right. Whereas when the polymerization is going to be carried by using two or more different types of monomer units. When the polymerization is carried by using two or more types of monomer units, then the polymerization is called as copolymerization, and the formed polymer is called as copolymer. So this was studied in the yesterday's class. Now in this class we are going to know what is condensation polymerization. How can we understand condensation? What is the meaning of condensation polymerization? So today's topic is about condensation polymerization. In your textbook, if you see the first page of the textbook, there you can find two examples. In the first page of your textbook, there you can find two examples. The first example given is formation of polythene. And the formation of polythene is an example of addition polymerization. Why? Because means polythene is formed from ethene. Ethene is an unsaturated monomer. So we can say that the polythene is an example of addition polymer. And polythene is obtained from only one type of monomer unit. Hence, polythene is an example of homopolymer. Now coming to the second example in your textbook, first page. In this chapter, in the first page, if you see the second example given as nylon 6,6, very, very, very important compound, nylon 6,6. It is an example of condensation polymer, and it is going to contain two monomers. The first monomer is hexamethylene diamine. This is the first monomer unit, methylene. Already you know that methylene group, single bond CH2 single bond group is called as methylene group. How many times it is taken? How many times it is taken? 6 times it is taken because hexamethylene. So methylene groups are of 6 times. Diamine. Amine means single bond NH2 group is called as amine. Diamine. How many amine groups are here? 2 amine groups are present here. So hexamethylene diamine is one of the monomer unit present in the nylon 6,6, and that is represented as NH2 single bond CH2 taken 6 times single bond NH2. That is the first monomer. And the second monomer is adipic acid. Adipic acid is the second monomer. Here adipic acid is also containing methylene groups. What is a methylene group? Single bond CH2 single bond group is called as methylene group. And here the methylene groups are of 4 times, whereas in the hexamethylene diamine methylene groups are of 6 times, whereas in adipic acid the methylene groups are of 4 times. Here acid means carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid, the group is written as C double bond O, single bond O, single bond H. Carboxylic acid group. Here again carboxylic acid group, C double bond O, single bond O, single bond H. So here we are discussing about condensation polymerization. The example is nylon 6,6. It is containing 2 different types of monomer units. The first monomer unit is hexamethylene diamine. The formula is represented as NH2 single bond CH2 taken 6 times single bond NH2. The second monomer unit is adipic acid, represented as single bond CH2 taken 4 times single bond COOH single bond COOH. Right, if you observe the 2 monomer units, what are the functional groups? What are the functional groups present in these monomer units? What are the functional groups present in these monomer units? What are the functional groups present in these monomer units? Can anybody text? What are the monomer units present? What are the functional groups? What are the functional groups present here? What are the functional groups present? Hexamethylene diamine is containing single bond NH2. Single bond NH2 means amine. That is a functional group. Adipic acid is containing single bond COOH. Single bond COOH called as carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid. Yes. Now tell me, in the nylon, in the formation of nylon 6,6, how many types of functional groups are there? How many types of functional groups are there? 2 different types of. How many types of functional groups are there here? 2 different types of functional groups are present. 2 different types of functional groups are present in the monomer units. 2 different types of functional groups are present in the monomer units. So to undergo condensation polymerization, the main condition is, this is the main condition. Once again, to undergo the condensation polymerization, the main condition is the monomer units must contain, the monomer units must contain 2 different types of functional groups. Once again, to undergo condensation polymerization, the monomer units must contain 2 different types of functional groups. Then only the polymerization is said to be condensation polymerization. Yes. What will happen in the condensation polymerization? Yes. Once again, I am taking nylon 6,6. you have to call it as nylon 6, 6. How it is going to be formed? How can we say it is a condensation polymer? Yes, first we are taking n molecules of hexamethylene diamine. N molecules of hexamethylene diamine is taken. This is the one of the monomer unit in the nylon 6, 6. The second monomer unit is adipic acid. Adipic acid is represented as COOH, single bond, CH2 taken four times, single bond, COOH. So this is the compound known as adipic acid. Adipic acid is containing carboxylic acid functional groups. COOH functional group is called as carboxylic acid functional group. Whereas hexamethylene diamine is containing amine functional group, that is single bond NH2. When these two are undergoing a polymerization reaction, what is going to happen? Very simple. From this NH2, suppose if this NH2 is written as single bond H, and here COOH is written as C double bond O, single bond OH. Yes, you can guess now. Here, H+ ion is going to be removed. Here, H+ ion is going to be removed. Here, OH- ion is going to be removed. H+ ion plus OH- ion. Water molecule is going to be removed. How many moles of? N moles of, or N molecules of water molecules are going to be removed. Yes, tell me, water molecule. This is the water molecule. With compare it to hexamethylene diamine, this one, and with compare it to adipic acid, this one, water molecule is a very simple molecule, very small molecule. So whenever large molecules having at least two different types of functional groups are undergoing a reaction, during that reaction, if removal of or elimination of or removal of small molecules like water molecule or ammonia molecule or HCl molecule or any other simple molecules are going to be removed during the polymerization, then such polymerization reactions are called as condensation polymerization reactions. So what is meant by condensation polymerization? When monomers having two or more different types of functional groups are undergoing a polymerization with the elimination of or with the removal of small molecules like water molecule or ammonia molecule or HCl molecules is going to take place. Such polymerization is called as condensation polymerization. Now, see this reaction. Hexamethylene diamine, where NH2 is going to lose H+ ion here. Adipic acid is going to lose OH- ion. That means N molecules of water molecules are going to be removed. That is, simple molecules are going to be removed. Then we can write. Here also H+ ion is going to be removed. Here, OH- ion is going to be removed. Then we can write it as NH. Here one H+ is removed. NH single bond, CH2 taken six times. Here NH is there. NH single bond. This NH group is going to be bonded to C double bond O. C double bond O. Single bond. CH2 taken four times. Single bond. C double bond O. Here OH- is removed. Then we can write single bond. These groups are repeated. These groups are repeated how many times? N times. Now this is the polymer called as This is the polymer called as nylon 6,6. Yes, you are having the textbooks. Please see the first page of this chapter. At the bottom of the page, you can see the formation of nylon 6,6. So once again, what are the monomer units of nylon 6,6? The first monomer unit is hexamethylene diamine, and the second monomer unit is adipic acid. During the polymerization of monomers having different functional groups, removal of simple molecules like water molecule or ammonia molecule or HCl molecule is going to take place. Then the formed polymer is called as condensation polymer, and the process is called as condensation polymerization. Yes. Now we can say that nylon 6,6 is an example of condensation polymerization. Okay, my dear students, please tell me whether nylon 6,6 is an example of homopolymer or copolymer. Once again, my question: whether nylon 6,6 is an example of homopolymer or copolymer? Yes, very good. Copolymer. Why? Because why it is a copolymer? Because nylon 6,6 is containing two different types of monomer units. Hence, nylon 6,6 is an example of copolymer. And of course, the process is called as condensation polymerization. Now, you can say that nylon 6,6 is an example of condensation polymer as well as copolymer. Did you understood? Text me, did you understood? Shall I repeat or continue? Did you understand? Remaining students, just watching to my class, please respond. If you respond, I can understand your situation. Yes, I will continue. Okay, fine, ma. Fine. Okay, fine. See this one, nylon 6,6. In this nylon 6,6, which group is present? In the nylon 6,6, which functional group is present? Text me your answer. In the structure nylon 6,6, I rounded off the functional group. What is the name of the functional group present in the nylon 6,6? Single bond NH, single bond C, double bond O, single bond. Yes, Shirant, it is correct answer. Single bond NH, single bond C, double bond O, single bond. This functional group is called as. Yes, correct. Amide functional group. So nylon 6,6 is containing amide functional group. The formula is represented as single bond NH, single bond C, double bond O, single bond. Now we can say that nylon 6,6 is a condensation polymer, nylon 6,6 is a copolymer, as well as nylon 6,6 is an example of poly, because taken n times means poly, and the functional group is amide. So now we can say that nylon 6,6 is an example of polyamide. If you have more the pages in your textbook, please move the pages. You can see in the third or fourth page, maybe in the fourth page or third page, you can see the heading
condensation polymerization.
Condensation polymerization also called as step growth polymerization. Step growth polymerization. Another name for the condensation polymerization is step growth polymerization. Right? So if I say the textbook, condensation polymerization or step growth polymerization, some examples are given. The first example given is Terlene or Decron. Please say the textbook, Terlene or Decron. I'm not going to discuss that one. I will discuss later. Say the next one, polyamides. In your textbook, in the fourth page of that chapter, the heading is condensation polymerization or step growth polymerization. The first one given as polyamides. So now you can see the polyamides from your textbook. The first example, polyamides. What is an example of polyamide? What is an example of polyamide? Nylon 6,6 is an example of polyamide. Yes, my dear students, uses are also given. Just you can read and understand the uses of nylon 6,6. Nylon 6,6 is used in making sheets and bristles for brushes. We are using a brush in the morning. The brush containing the bristles, that bristles are made up of nylon 6,6. So this is all about condensation polymerization, and nylon 6,6 is an example of copolymer and it is a polyamide. Right, in the textbook you can see the second example in the polyamides. In the polyamides you can see the second example that is given as nylon 6. The second example given is nylon 6. So we are moving to the second example. Example 2. And the example I am taking is nylon 6. You have to understand the difference between nylon 6,6 and nylon 6. Here I am saying about nylon 6. Here nylon 6 is containing only one monomer. Only one monomer is present. One type of monomer units. One type of monomer units are present in nylon 6, nylon 6. Once again the statement. The nylon 6 is containing only one type of monomer units, and the monomer unit is caprolactam. Caprolactam. Important one. Caprolactam is the monomer unit. Caprolactam is the monomer unit present in the nylon 6. Then you can say that, sir, it is containing only one type of monomer units. Hence, we can say that nylon 6 is an example of homopolymer. Okay, now you will get it out. Sir, what is meant by caprolactam? How can we write the caprolactam? So, here it is the concept, preparation of nylon 6 from caprolactam. Yes, caprolactam, I'm going to take amide. Amide group. What is the amide group? What is the amide group? Single bond, NH, single bond, C, double bond, O, single bond. This functional group is called as amide functional group. So now we can say that nylon 6 is also containing amide functional group. Amide functional group. And the functional group is represented as single bond, NH, single bond, C, double bond, O, single bond. Now, we are saying that the monomer of nylon 6 is caprolactam. Caprolactam, that is represented as single bond, NH, single bond, C, double bond, O, single bond. Yes, see here, 6 is there. 6 is there. That 6 is indicating 6 carbons. The 6 is indicating 6 carbons are present in the monomer. What is the monomer? Caprolactam is a monomer that is going to contain how many carbons? 6 carbons. Here one carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon, and sixth carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes, those who are having the textbook, you can see the structure very clearly from your textbook. The topic is polyamides. In the topic condensation polymerization or step growth polymerization, the first topic given as polyamides. In that polyamides, the second example given is nylon 6. The monomer unit of nylon 6 is caprolactam. This is the structure of caprolactam. It is containing the functional group. What is the functional group? Single bond NH, single bond C, double bond O, single bond. Yes. How many molecules we have to take? N molecules we have to take. It is undergoing polymerization. When this is undergoing polymerization, then we will get nylon 6. Very simple. Here, break this bond between NH and CO. Suppose here, one hydrogen is going to be added. This group becomes as NH2. That is one functional group. Here, suppose if we are going to add OH group, then the functional group is COOH. COOH is called as carboxylic acid. NH2 is called as amine. So how many functional groups are present here means two different types of functional groups are present. But of course, in general, if you consider here only one functional group is present. Single bond NH, single bond C, double bond O. When the bond is going to be broken between these NH and C double bond O, then the group formed is represented as single bond. This is the one, single bond NH, single bond CH2 groups. How many CH2 groups are present? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the methylene groups, what is meant by methylene? Single bond CH2 single bond group is called as methylene group. How many times it is? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. That is taken 5 times. Now this group is there, CO group is there, that is C double bond O single bond. These groups are repeated n times. This is the structure of nylon 6. Right. Suppose here one hydrogen is added. What is the functional group? NH2. Suppose here OH group is added. Here the functional group is COOH. So this caprolactam actually is going to contain two different types of functional groups, but that is undergoing cyclization. Then we are getting the caprolactam. This is the structure. When it is undergoing polymerization, what is going to remove? Removal of N molecules or N moles of water molecule. Water molecule is which type of molecule? Water molecule is a simple molecule. So during the polymerization reaction, whenever simple molecules like water molecule or ammonia molecule or HCl molecule is going to be removed, such polymerization is called as condensation polymerization, otherwise also called as step growth polymerization. Yes, it is an important one. Now the question will arise, what is the difference between nylon 6 and nylon 6,6? If you understand this topic, you can easily guess the answer. What is the main difference? What is the major difference between nylon 6,6 and nylon 6? Number of carbons. Okay, fine. Tell me. In nylon 6,6, how many types of monomer units are present? In the nylon 6,6, how many types of monomer units are present? Yes. So we can say that nylon 6,6 is an example of copolymer, whereas nylon 6 is an example of, regarding the number of monomer units, regarding the type of monomer units, Nylon 6 is an example of, yes, correct, homopolymer. Nylon 6 is an example of homopolymer. Correct answer. So simply we can say that nylon 6 comma 6 is an example of copolymer. Nylon 6 is an example of homopolymer. That is the main difference between nylon 6 comma 6 and nylon 6. Once again, on the board, I'm going to write the main difference between, according to the type of polymerization, nylon 6 comma 6 is a copolymer, whereas nylon 6 is a homopolymer. Homopolymer, right? This is the main difference. Okay, fine. What is the similarity? What is the similarity between nylon 6 and nylon 6 comma 6? So this is the difference. This is the difference between nylon 6 comma 6 and nylon 6. Yes, what is the similarity? What is the similarity between nylon 6 comma 6 and nylon 6? Yeah, my dear students, if you see the structures of nylon 6 comma 6 and nylon 6, both are containing amide functional group. Amide functional group. So nylon 6 comma 6, nylon 6 comma 6 and nylon 6 are, text me your answer. Nylon 6 comma 6 and nylon 6 are dash type of monomers. Polyamides. They are the polyamides. Here in the blank, what is the answer? They are the examples of polyamides. Amide means which functional group they are going to contain. Single bond NH, single bond C, double bond O, single bond. How many times they are going to contain? N times. So the similarity between nylon 6, comma 6 and nylon 6 is both are the examples of polyamides. And one more thing, polyamides are the examples of condensation polymers. So the similarity between nylon 6 comma 6 and nylon 6 are both are polyamides. That means both are the examples of condensation polymers. But the difference is nylon 6 6 is going to contain two different types of monomers, hence it is a copolymer, whereas nylon 6 is going to contain only one type of monomer units, means it is a homopolymer. Yes, take the screenshot. Based on nylon 6 comma 6 and nylon 6, repeatedly the bits is going to be asked. Did you understand? Did you understand? Why you are lazy to text the answer? Why you are lazy to text your response? Because of cold. Okay, fine. And in the textbook, you can see the second topic, polyesters. Simply, we can say that polyester. We are using the different types of cloths. One type of cloth, that is the polyester or polyester. So again, this is also an example of condensation polymerization. The second example for condensation polymers is, first of all, the first example is polyamides are the examples of condensation polymers. Now the second example is polyesters or polyesters. In the next class, we will discuss. The time is very less. Of course, here we studied about polyamides. The two examples we studied is nylon 6 comma 6 and nylon 6. Thank you, my dear students, for watching the video lecture. Please practice the MCQs from your material. Right? Tomorrow, of course, there is no class.